Wanted to talk about the new Liquidsky stuff. This is the 2.1 Liquidsky update. I think you'll notice something. Well, once it connects, the interface has no controller support, so you can't do that. That's not the thing. So that's just a little whatever. So these do nothing. So you can click on them, do whatever, doesn't do anything. They're just like static images, possibly with some text on top of them. This doesn't do anything. You can check the news. This doesn't do anything. You can click here, but most of the times it doesn't work. I live in the U.S. Ads are available in the U.S. and I've only seen one ad, and so they got to get together more people, more ads, more stuff, so you can use the service for free. The Sky Lounge is non-existent, so it's coming soon, and there's a little bit of a faded, I guess, idea of what they're going to put there. Then we have these plans here you can click on. Pay as you go, you only get 100 gigabytes. I did try the monthly because I wanted the 500 gigabytes. I wanted to show some things on YouTube and try it out. And 100 gigabytes is not really anything unless you only want to play some indie titles or one AAA title and an indie title or maybe two smaller AAA titles or something. So that's not going to work very well for that. So I tried the monthly with the intention of I'm probably going to cancel the monthly, but you never know, maybe I won't. I don't know. So you click here, they have all these different plans here. You click there where it says view plans, and apparently nothing happens. And it acts up. Okay, so yeah, there's a lot of bugs. There's like a novel of bugs with this. There's no way to go into full screen without a keyboard, so you have to hit F11, so you can't just use an on-screen thing. I'm going to relaunch this and see if that fixes the pay as you are viewing, whatever, that bug that I just had. So now it's saying, we need to create a firewall. Every single time it says you need to create a firewall exception. That's the intro. Woohoo! I could have sworn they said they were going to allow us to skip that. You can create a new account, migrate, log in, whatever, whatever. So I'm going to hit F11 to go into full screen. And hopefully I can actually go to the Sky Store. They may have disabled it, I don't know. Nope, they didn't. Okay. So you can start off with $4.99 for like $5. You get 720 Sky credits, up to 12 hours of gaming, you know, and all the way up to $100 for 375 hours of gaming. But then you'll only have 99, or 100 gigabytes of storage, which doesn't really make sense if you were going to spend $100 to get 375 hours of gaming. I would assume that you were more interested in playing games and that you would probably go with a monthly plan, not sit there with 100 gigabytes, but it seems like an unnecessary plan, but whatever. Now you go to the monthly, it starts at $9.99. There's three plans here, up to $40. There's no unlimited like they had before. That was, I guess, a while ago they got rid of it. I don't know. I wouldn't pay for that anyways. I was more interested in the free things. I'm hoping there's a way to get into the free plan and, you know, maybe get more storage by adding, you know, with credits or something. Give them, they used to have it where you could give them X amount of credits that you had and you could get more storage. I don't know if you could still, if they will let you do that again. So we go back home. Like I mentioned, these don't do anything. Let me see if I can try. Oh, we can watch an ad. If there's any reason I need to lower the audio for the ad, there you go. Now you can't hear the audio. This is the only ad I've ever been able to see. It's an ad for Windows 10 HP Spectre, whatever. And sometimes it'll actually tell you that you don't get any credits when you do this. I had it last time. And it seems like you can only... Okay, so then I have to wait for this timer. Okay, I don't see any way to get out of here. Let me see if I can hit the escape key. Okay. Yeah, the ad's not working, right? Let me see if I hit I'm done. Thanks for watching. You earned 20 Sky credits. So there you go. Last time I actually earned 0 Sky credits. That was excellent. Let me try to hit it again and see what happens. Okay. Well, I actually got more. Click video to start. Okay, so I got to play the video. Okay, and now it's actually bringing me to... Alright, I don't want it to do that. But... So now I guess I got to wait for this ad to play. Some of the bugs I've been having with the service is controller support is really terrible. They said they were going to work on that. Hopefully in the next patch, it will fix controller support. And I got 8 Sky credits. Let's try again. Nope, nothing. It says, currently no opportunities available. Try again later. Alright, so yeah, controller support has been rough. I tried playing Grand Theft Auto. And... the analog stick seemed to be mapped as an analog stick, but it also as a D-pad, so I would have two conflicting controls going on and stuff, so that's sucked. And then I have an issue where there would be a virtual keyboard will pop up randomly for no apparent reason. I won't even be touching a button, and all of a sudden a virtual keyboard pops up, and I have to hit B to get out of it. And it actually reacts in the game, so then it causes me to do whatever the hell B does. Which makes it really hard to control the games. A lot of people have had other bugs. Like I said, there's a huge list of bugs that they need to fix. They said they've been working on it and stuff, of course. You know, I personally believe that they are working on it. I mean, I don't know why they wouldn't be. I think they want their service to be successful. I want their service to be successful, even if I bitch about it sometimes. I did post a few videos. I forget if I deleted it. If not, I gotta check, but I could have sworn I deleted the videos that I posted. See here, you notice that this is supposed to have a wallpaper, but it's a black screen instead, and a lot of times the wallpaper disappears, and sometimes the entire screen disappears. Okay, so I also set, let me raise this. I also set Steam Big Picture Mode to start up with Liquidsky, so that it, chances are I'm going to want to game using Big Picture Mode for a controller. Mouse and keyboard is supported. I suck with a mouse and keyboard, though. I'm the complete opposite. I play better with a mouse and keyboard. I mean, I play better with a controller than I do with a mouse and keyboard. So, but I'm used to playing consoles for most of my life. Now, my PC is, it's powerful enough to play some newer games at some decent settings, but, you know, there are certain games I bought, like Doom, that just run like total ass, and I actually stopped playing it because of its performance issues. And with my PC, and I couldn't play it at a respectable frame rate or anything. It had stuttering and everything. Now with Liquidsky, I can actually play it at 60 frames per second with maxed out. So, and that's with the Pro plan. If you see, I selected that because it seems like, and they have said that the Elite is kind of pointless and all it does is drain your credits. There's not really many reasons to use Elite. So for this, I would use the Pro. I didn't really have too many issues playing this. You'll notice that there's this weird flicker and judder when I move the analog stick. I think that's because the analog stick is mapped as also the D-pad. So it gets that kind of like I'm pressing a button twice look like. If I hit, you know, if I hit the D-pad twice, you get that. But you'll see that judder in there because the controller mapping is fucked up. I'm going to launch the game. I've had mixed results with this too. Like yesterday I was playing Doom fine, 60 FPS, and then I launched it again later on and all of a sudden it was like it was struggling to keep 30. So I don't know, maybe there was something, they were doing some work or there was something going on server side, or maybe it was just like a lot of people accessing the service. But I was getting like really low frame rates all of a sudden with the same settings, same everything. So the game launches. Oh, I forgot to, you can, let me go, F12 unlocks the settings here and a few other things. So you can use a mouse. And then you go here and I can uncheck auto bitrate and drag the slider up to get better quality. And then I think that's it. Everything's set to 1080p, 60 FPS. You can also set it to unlimited, but I have a 60 hertz monitor, so I guess maybe that, I don't know. So yeah, let's I was playing this for a little while. Let's just play it again. Right now I have the frame rate up here. This is a 4K monitor, or TV actually, not a very good one, but it's it locks the sharpness when you have a 4K source, and then the sharpness is too high, so it looks all fucked up if you don't have a perfect image. Okay, so the latency seems really good. It's really, you know, I don't see too many people complain. I think there may be some people that would be too sensitive to it, but for me, it seems perfectly fine. And this is running, as you see the frame rate counter, it does slightly dip to like maybe 59 frames per second for like a fraction of a millisecond. Boom. That did nothing, except for that. Ah, oh, fuck. Oh, I got it, okay. So, you know. So, this is a hell of a lot better than what I was playing before. And there is some artifacting here and there. I thought a dead body just fell down. Anyways, there is some artifacting here and there, but that's another thing with my monitor is that it will let you know if there's artifacting. It's not the world's best, or TV, not monitor. I'll just die already. Still, what the fuck? Get up there. Okay, whatever. So I mean, it's running fairly well with you know, with enemies and everything on the screen. I'm not really playing any bit seriously, although I never really play seriously. But yeah, if for some reason you're into some kind of competitive gaming or whatever, you may not want to use this. You may want to just look into some local hardware if you can. But if you just like to play for fun like I do, yeah, hello notifications, then you should be able to, whatever. I don't even remember what I was saying, but yeah. Oh, what do you guys want? What the hell? He just spun around. Okay, so oops. See, that's what I was talking about with the keyboard just popping up out of nowhere. Fuck you, dead body. Anyway, so that's Doom. Because I have it set to big picture mode, I can just actually, let me see if I I can't use the guide button, but I can hit shift tab. I hit exit. Come on, man. Controller's a little screwy, but now we can just close out of the game, and then. And of course, on top of gaming, because this is a actual computer, or PC, you can also do things like load up Sony Vegas and do some video editing, which I was able to do. I was able to record the screen using, it should be there somewhere, OBS Studio. I recorded the screen, and I was able to bring the video into Vegas and actually upscale the video for YouTube to 4K, and it was a lot faster than if I used my PC, so here's that. So you can just run regular old programs on it. You could even use it for work if you wanted, so that's cool. They are supposed to have more operating systems coming. They did say Android was going to be one of them. I don't know what to do with that, but you could, I guess. As far as like supported platforms for Liquidsky, so far right now Windows is it. For not only for the actual client for your system, but for the actual systems that you can actually stream. So you can only stream Windows, and you can only install it on Windows right now. But they said they're going to support more operating systems to install it onto and to stream. So far, every game that I've played on the pro plan has been able to be maxed out 60 frames per second, and you, of course, can go higher than that. They do offer higher than 60 frames per second, where it says unlimited, so you can do that. So I did install GeForce Experience. You cannot update the drivers for GeForce Experience. It also does not support like GameStream or anything like that, so you know, there's no share features, or I wouldn't be using OBS. So yeah, there's no share features, there's, you know, it's fairly bare bones, and you can't update the drivers either. So if you go, see, it says game stream not ready, share not ready, virtual reality not ready. Let me check, let me go to the drivers, and you'll see it says Tesla drivers for Windows. And it says download. If I hit download, it will just say downloading, and then it says retrying. It's going to fail eventually, but so it doesn't work. So there is that. And yeah, so I played some Call of Duty on here. I suck at it, so I couldn't really tell you. Like I said, if you're like a competitive gamer or something like that, you're probably going to stay away from that. We have this speed test. People have seen that before, but I'll play it anyways. The only thing I haven't tried, I don't know why I want to try this. This is really stupid. But I want to try downloading Liquidsky on Liquidsky and running Liquidsky through Liquidsky to see how that would perform. Totally pointless, but I don't know. So there we go, 830 megabytes per second. They don't show you everything. Let me compare it, speed test on that. And then we can run that. And yeah, it downloads really fast. The stuff does download. Oops, hit the camera. Stuff does download very fast, so it's very good for big AAA games. They will download a hell of a lot faster than on your connection normally. So that's that. My actual connection is 55 up, no, 55 down, and up is like 20-something. So the service runs fairly well on my connection. I actually can't get a lower connection than that even if I wanted to. They don't offer that anymore, which I like. I don't want lower connections. If the cheapest connection is way better than the connection I had before, that's great for me. Yeah. So yeah, and you can browse the web with it if you wanted to. I would think that you would probably want to just handle that locally, browsing the web. unless you're trying to download some huge file or something, and you want to run it on here. But just regular casual web browsing would be a waste of credits and stuff. So yeah, there's that. Of course, you can also run more advanced software on here. You'd be able to run whatever, some, you know, 3D video editing type stuff. If you want to make movies and stuff, should be a lot better for that. Like to load up, I have Movie Storm. I'd like to try that out. I haven't used that program in a really long time. I'm sure there's been a million updates to that ever since I last used it. So everything seems to be very stable. I do not run into like mountains of crashes. I think they're running a special type of Windows. I forget what the hell it's called. It's something Windows. Yeah, something Windows, and it's got a Windows 10 thing on top or whatever the fuck. But it runs Windows stuff, and apparently is less capable of getting viruses. I don't know. I have no clue. I don't even know why I'm talking. I have no clue what I'm talking about. I'm just repeating things that people have said. The one weird thing I thought was here. You go here, and there's a CD drive. What am I going to do with the CD drive? What am I going to go travel to their location and put a CD in it? Unless, of course, they can... Actually, I don't think that it reads my CDs, because I have a DVD in my drive. So I don't know what I'm going to do with a CD drive, unless you can mount something on it. It can be mounted. I don't see anything like that. I don't know, maybe there's a way to mount a ISO image to it? I don't know. But there's a CD drive there, and I just don't see a reason for it. You can't plug in, except for a controller, you can't really plug in USB hardware. So there's no adding a USB drive right now. They have talked about it, I don't know what else they do there. Let me free up some space here. Get rid of this stuff. Alright. Not exactly going to free up too much. But anyways, I've also run emulators on this Wii U. I haven't put Launchbox on here or anything, because I believe you only get one install per computer, and I only, you know, then you have to purchase it again. So I'm not going to buy it again, just so I can load it up on here, but maybe there's a way you can do that, I don't know. So, yeah. And I have not gotten my wallpaper back. So, but yeah, there's a lot of things that people are annoyed about with the way the company has handled this, such as a lot of stuff that I can't even remember, there's so much of it. However, it is funny to see them get all pissed off, scream at the people on the forums, and then when you go into a live stream, they're all nice and like, "Hi, how you doing?" I understand why they're pissed, but yeah, that's a long list of things that the company could have done way better, or maybe they couldn't have. I don't think I could have. I fucking would have been worse. I'd have been, you know, they've been coming, banging, knocking my fucking door down and stabbing me to death. So anyways, that's that. And I think, really, they did talk about, I wanted to point out something in the live stream, they talked about how they may take down the Elite servers or something like that, along those lines, or they may limit the Elite servers because people are using them a lot because they want the power, and apparently it's causing problems for them. And I don't know if they actually already did that or if they stop or if they, yeah, I don't know. But I stopped using the Elite servers for not only for that, but because I don't really need them, and it's a waste of credits. So far the experience has been very good. The performance, at least, has been very good. The bugs with the controller, they're annoying, so I hope they fix those soon, and hopefully they can add back all the features that they took out from the first release, the first beta, because there's no recording, there's no streaming. You have to use your own software for that. So no built-in recording, streaming. Controller support is a little screwy. A lot of things that I can't remember, but they have a lot to do. They have a lot of work, and you know they better hurry up because I want to sit here like a lazy fuck and play video games. God damn it. Anyways, so let's get out of here. I'm gonna end my desktop here. Did I show everything? Oh. I don't know if I showed this. This is the mouse gamer mode, which honestly, I guess it does something. I've turned it off and on, and I don't notice the difference. The controller pass through, of course, you can use your controller. That has a tendency to conflict when you're trying to use the mouse and keyboard. So you have a lot of problems where you're firing, you know, you're playing a shooting game and you're automatically firing. But turn that off if you're going to use a mouse and keyboard. Setup controller doesn't do anything, it doesn't work except for it fucks up your controller even more, and then you'll have to download an INI file or copy and paste lines from an INI file into an INI file, and then whatever, but... So if you screw it up, you're fucked, basically. You go here, and of course here's your, you know, resolution and quality settings and all that, and... This is where you can go back home without ending the computer. You time out, so you can set your timeout. This will time out in 20 minutes by default. You can set it to not time out at all, which probably will wipe through your credits, I would guess. Or you can set it 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour. I think people had problems with the 20 minutes thing. I have been okay, so I'm leaving it. I'm gonna quit Sky Computer and go back to my peasant computer. I don't know that this would, how much this would benefit you if you actually had a high-end computer. There's like, some guy was talking about how he had a 1080, GTX 1080, and I don't know if he had, what CPU he had, but he had this really high-end computer, and he's like, well, you know, I've been using this, it's not as good as my high-end gaming PC, and I'm like, what's the point in using this? Especially if you have a GTX 1080, you can stream that over the internet with, you know, using GeForce Experience and all that. So, I mean, I could do that with my PC, but it just doesn't work as well. It's a peasant PC. So, that's that, and, you know... I can't think of anything else, but yeah, so thank you for watching.